evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the planning board meeting of September 9th. I ask you to please rise and pledge allegiance to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. On a personal note, before we do roll call, John Ranieri's wife is, she's in the hospital right now, and I believe she is still unconscious since 8 o'clock this morning, so if you could offer a prayer to her sometime this evening, that would be nice of you. John is telling me that the next 24 hours are critical. She was in a bicycle accident today, so John will not be here with us tonight. He's with his wife, and we want to extend our prayers to him and Mary Jo and her family. Thank you. We have roll call, please, Jim.
Clayhammer?
Yes.
Dickinson?
Yes.
Bushian?
Yes.
Bajowski?
Yes.
Fullerton?
Yes.
Offerman?
Here.
Chief Daly?
Here.
And Ranieri is absent.
Excused, Eric Potts is at the funeral, he's excused as well.
Okay. Dennis Manella?
Here.
Bobbinstein?
Yep, very good, here.
Rowan?
Here.
Ed is excused. I don't know where he is.
I don't know where he is either, but he should be here.
Okay, thank you. Public notice of this meeting pursuant to the Open Public Meeting Act has been given by the clerk in the following manner: posted on the bulletin board in the borough clerk's office, emailed to retrospect, and the courier post. The first order of business will be the approval of the minutes from the previous meeting, which was August 12th, 2015. Is there a motion?
That's not good.
Mr. Dickinson, seconded by Mr. Bajowski. Any questions? All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Thank you. Under new business, we have a resolution. Mr. Rowan.
Yes, a solid partnership doing business is Horizon, 303 North Black Horse Pike, Lot 43, Lot 9. This serves as a use variance to permit the installation of telecommunication antennas and equipment. I think the only other thing, the conditions that were put on this was that they had to get approvals any other local, state, or county agencies, which may be required.
That's
all that, yes. Okay.
We have roll call, Jim, please.
Do we make a motion yet?
Okay, I'm sorry. Need a motion to approve the resolution as read.
So moved.
Second, Mrs. Gushman. Second, Mr. Dickinson. Roll call, please.
Clayhammer?
Yes.
Dickinson?
Yes.
Offerman?
Abstained.
Bushian?
Yes.
Bajowski?
Yes.
Chief Daly's yes.
What?
Chief Daly's yes.
I didn't get to
you. You're not next. You're not next. You have to wait your turn.
Fullerton?
Mr. Fullerton. Yeah, let's be from Fort County.
Mr. Yes.
Daly?
Yes.
Ron, were you here for that one?
I wasn't.
Manella.
Yes.
I'm sorry?
I wasn't.
Last month, were you here, Ron?
No.
Okay, for that.
Wasn't that the month before?
No, we did that last month.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Mr. Fulton will abstain on that one, okay?
Yep. Thank you, Ron.
He was here in spirit.
Mr. Ryan, we have resolution 15013.
Yeah, the next one is John Markolix, 914 East Clinton Bridge Road, Lot 146, Lot 7. This was a minor site plan expansion of a non-conforming use variance with bulk variance and waivers. The applicant presented a plan where he wanted to install and construct a 1,200-foot square foot storage garage. The board found that this was a good for the public since the majority of the work that this gentleman performs is on state police vehicles. I won't go over every condition, but the applicant, I do recite the review letter, John's review letter, and the requirements that the applicant agreed to, and the waivers which were granted pursuant to John's letter.
Thank you. We have a motion to adopt the resolution as read.
Yes, I do so.
All right. Chief Daly, and seconded by Mr. Dickinson. Roll call, please, Jim.
Clayhammer?
Yes.
Dickinson?
Yes.
Bushian?
Yes.
Bajowski?
Yes.
Fullerton?
Abstain.
Offerman?
Abstain.
Daly?
Yes.
And Mr.?
And Vanilla.
Yes.
I remembered you.
Okay. Under old business, it doesn't really matter what this comes under, I put it under old business. Mr. and Mr. Light is not here right this second, but there was a, an informal that we had in the October 14th meeting, and it was on the Lindsay Avenue property. A gentleman came in and he was going to put an electrical supply company in, I believe. And we listened to what he had to say. And during the informal, we did mention to him, though site plan required, it would say that the type of business was a good fit for the commercial district. And the only thing that the planning board would like to see was to address the driveway and the parking lot because the paving was in disrepair. Pursuant to that, I believe the gentleman did close on the property. I was by there on Monday. He has made improvements to the building as well as the improvements to the parking lot and the apron. Mr. Light went out to the property and noted that the gentleman does have an excess of impervious on the property, but that really was a pre-existing condition. I did have a conversation with our planning board engineer. I deferred to his expertise because I know he was at the property as well. And the communication from him is as follows. Handy for our conversation, not needing a variance for impervious surface coverage, assuming the lot now exceeds it, would be if the conditions prior to paving a lot were impervious as well. Existing gravel surface was hard packed, and we had considered that impervious at the time. So basically, what I think our engineer is saying to us is that the gentleman did not take out any trees, any shrubbery, any islands. He did not take out any non-impervious areas of the parking lot and make that impervious. He did not expand upon an impervious lot. He simply did what we asked him to do and improve the lot for the safety of the residents and the safety of the people coming in and out of the facility. So to that end, I think we should recommend to Mr. Knight that this was indeed a condition that we did not impose upon. We suggested to that applicant at the time of his informal application, and that it wasn't an expansion of impervious, it was simply an improvement that we requested, and as such, we do not believe there should be a need for a variance. Is there any comments on that, Mr. Rowan?
No, I agree with you, Madam Chair. I spoke to John on this matter also, and it appears that what the man did was request, I didn't have a recollection of it, because I don't take notes on informals, but apparently the board, somebody suggested that he pay that to, yes.
We review the tape to that and verify.
Yeah, and that's, and basically what was there was impervious coverage from what John was still saying. So hard time, so he didn't expand it. I don't believe the variance is necessary.
Does anyone else have any problems with that? Okay. Mr. Rand, do we need to take any action to let Mr. Knight know?
No, no. I would just come as connected to the board's, you know, premise that it was hard back and it was not an expansion.
Right. I mean, I agree with you, he's doing the right thing. He's going by the law.
Yeah, and he's looking after the benefit of the community.
And
absolutely.
It should come back to us.
But, yeah, but I don't, John and I don't feel that the man expanded.
Right.
And as we said, apparently we told him that that's what the board or the community would like to see.
Yes.
Because it was,
and he did
I guess, a bad condition.
Right. It was in disrepair, so, and it was actually dangerous, so I think.
Yeah. So he made an improvement to one of our businesses.
So I guess I will contact Mr. Knight and
if Keith has any questions, tell me to get my office.
Sure. And I have Mr. Pettit's email, I can forward to Keith as well.
Mm-hmm. No problem.
Is there anything else under old business? Communications, June, anything? Okay. Good and welfare. At this point in time, I'd like to open up the meeting to the public. Anyone wishing to speak on any matter whatsoever, please come forward, state your name and be heard.
Seeing no interest, I move to the public portion to be closed.
Motion's been made.
Second.
Second by Mrs. Goshen, public portion be closed. Thank you. Okay, is there any other thing you want to go over? Any problems, conditions, anything you need to chat about? Anything you swear?
About the guy down on Schubert on the corner that had the retaining wall.
Haven't heard anything from her. No, I mean, no news, I guess, is good news, because he would come every month, so I'm hoping that they came to some resolution. I'm hoping Judge Trigwash got involved and kind of got that moving.
Yeah, that's where it was.
That's where it was headed.
That Mrs. Stilinski?
Yeah, that's where it was heading, so. With that, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
No motion.
Okay, Mr. Opperly and Mr. Dickens, all in favor?
Aye.
All right. Adjourn at 7:11.